Where are all the cane farms?
Mate, I'm looking for your farm. I'm sure I'm on the right road. That's right, these guys are growing all those funny cover crops.
The main purpose in using cover crops is to improve the soil health for your main cash crops. But in many cases, cover crops can also give you a cash return, and this can help you with farm income while also improving your soil's health. But whichever species of seeds you use, there are three main approaches. The first is to do a single species cover crop in rotation with your main cash crop. An example up here in the wet tropics is soybeans grown in rotation with sugarcane, or peanuts grown in rotation with a cash crop. The second approach to cover cropping is growing a multi-species cover crop. This is where you grow more than two species at the same time in rotation with your cash crops. Many growers are trialling 4-way, 6-way, 8-way, or even over 10 different species as part of that cover crop rotation.
On our fallow crops, we grow legumes and grass seed that we do harvest and supply hay to the cattle industry.
In this mixed species cover crop here, there's field brassica, tillage radish, triticale, Rhodes grass and Japanese millet.
Sun hemp, soybean, sunflower, lab.
The third main approach is called intercropping, where you grow a complementary cover crop in with your main cash crop. An example is growing sunflowers in with sugarcane at the same time. Recent science is really showing that this increased diversity has a number of important benefits to your farming system. The first big benefit it gives you is you improve soil health. You can increase soil organic matter, improve soil structure, and improve the biological health of the soil, which can often lead to reduced soil-borne disease issues.
And it just looks healthier. It's full of fungi, as all the other stuff's breaking down, which is in the long term is a plus, and tends to hold the moisture better.
The second big benefit is nutrient management. Legume cover crops help bring in nitrogen, but a lot of the other cover crop species help to access and cycle other nutrients like phosphorus, sulfur, and trace elements.
With soybeans, we've done heaps of trials. The nitrogen we're getting out of the soybean crop is enough to grow the first plant crop.
My nitrogen regime has changed a lot over the years. Probably when I started to shift across, I was 180 units per hectare user. Now I'm 120 maximum.
A third benefit is weed control and weed management. Growing a vigorous, thick cover crop on a paddock instead of leaving it bare just minimises the spaces for weeds to take over.
So here we've planted our second cover crop. So I've found that having a good cover crop like you see here, it really manages the weeds. Simply there's no room there for weeds to grow. I think without this cover crop there would be a good crop of bluetop here right now.
Finally, cover crops as part of your farming system can actually become valuable cash crops when they're done right.
What I'm obviously looking for is if I make some money out of that soybean crop, why not just sell the seed, especially now when there's a drought out west and there is a shortage of that product. You're still getting the nitrogen fixing, but you're actually making a little bit of money on the side.
There's the odd sunflower.
If you're thinking to implement a cover cropping strategy, there's a couple of things you need to have success. The first one is to have a really clear idea of what you're trying to achieve, what your agronomic outcomes are. Are you trying to deal with specific soil health issues like compaction, poor soil organic matter? Are you trying to improve nutrient cycling in your soil, weed control, or have you got disease issues in your cash crops that a cover crop can help overcome? The next step is to select the right tactic to use. Are you going to go with a multi-species cover crop, intercropping, or just a single species cover crop in rotation? You need to decide which species and varieties of crops are going to be appropriate for your soil type and your climate. You're going to have to decide on the timing, whether you're going to do a cool season or a wet season cover crop, and you're going to decide on how long you want the cover crop to grow. Once the cover crop's growing, they're usually fairly low maintenance. The goal is to grow as big a plant biomass above ground and below ground as possible in your crop cycle window. During the cover crop period, you need to be happy with a bit of mess. A large amount of messy biomass of plants is okay. If you've done good soil preparation and planning, then you'll get the most out of the cover crops. The last thing you're going to have to think about is how to terminate it before you go back into your cash crops. You can physically incorporate them with tillage equipment, like slashing, mowing, or shallow incorporation. You can also spray them out with chemicals. Another tactic is to use a crop roller to roll down the cover crop. And finally, you can use livestock to graze them out.
Before we terminated the crop, the legumes were almost waist high, just flowering, so optimum amount of nitrogen in the legumes. The crop will now stay on top of the soil as soil cover until the weather's good enough for us to plant cane. Incorporate the legumes, which will supply nitrogen to our plant crop of cane.
Successfully implementing cover crops into your farming system is a really important way to improve the sustainability and the profitability in the long term. If you can take that new approach, you're going to get some serious benefits.
As you can see, this is the soil out of the mixed species cover crop, and this is a soil out of an adjacent paddock. So that soil is going to be pretty dead and compacted. So I know which one I prefer, definitely this one.
But all this stuff's doing a job and we need it.
So if you want to learn more about how to implement a cover cropping strategy on your place, contact your local extension officer, Terrain NRM, or go to the links at the end of the video.